So a lot of folks think about enterprise security or enterprise IT security, but operations security or OT, operations technology, they're just different. And they have different threats, different mission, different everything. And so the security controls and mechanisms that you're going to want to do are going to invariably be different to reduce a different type of cyber risk. The other aspect that I'll sort of layer onto that is everything is OT. And so usually people think, oh, it's electric utilities or oil and gas, but it's data centers, it's rail, it's the football stadiums that we have, it's water, it's everything. And so everyone probably has some level of OT in their environments or in their companies. Some of them, they are an OT company really, and the IT is the aftermath. And we need to work together and figure out how to approach that security correctly, especially from like the human element, right? The theme of this. Too often folks really try to bifurcate the community. And it's appropriate to treat IT and OT security differently, but it's not good to actually treat us all like we're not the right people or like you don't have the right people on the team. You can approach it differently and it's still all the same community, especially when you start talking about the lack of visibility we have. Most companies aren't monitoring in their industrial networks or in industrial environments to even see what's going on. So to pretend that something is not facing us is quite silly. If we hear about a threat, we should take that and go, okay, well, is it in my environment? Is it relevant to my industry? What would the lessons learned? And even if it's not, what can we learn from that anyways as we start approaching our industrial security? A lot of folks want to do asset inventory, which is, it's not a bad thing. It makes sense, but it's not just about the inventory. It's about how everything's communicating, the topology of it, like what's going on. So we can actually understand if there are threats or risks and how to get ahead of it. And I think that we're struggling on that. Like we're getting better. Community's doing good overall, but you know, it's slow. And I would say probably the other piece is a lot of folks don't understand this side of the world, so they want to flavor it as something they do understand. So we see industrial commonly getting told as, it's IoT. Well, all those weird stuff, it's IoT. But there's no better way to piss off the plant operations folks and walk in and be like, oh yeah, you're IoT. Like, no, that's Alexa. The gas turbine's a little bit different. And we need to make sure we approach it that way. So here's where I think will be the short term, the midterm, and the long term of this. The short term is we're going to go get more visibility than we've ever had before. And it's going to look like this hockey stick that things are getting real bad. And I go and tell people, like, calm down. It's actually a maturity curve. Because we are looking more, we are seeing more. So it's not that our asset owners and power and water and oil and gas and folks aren't doing good work. It's they're doing more work than ever. So it's going to look real bad in the short term. Now, in the medium term, I do want people to be ready for what bad can look like. We have threats that are trying to kill people. We have threats that have shown the ability to take down electric power. It's going to happen. And my fear is that we overreact in the fear. We try to regulate away the industry or just really freak out. And the reality is it's gonna happen eventually, but we have such good asset owners and operators and a good community that we're gonna be okay. Maybe a 30-minute outage isn't the thing to really freak out about and overreact on. So it's gonna happen, so be ready for it. But in the long term, the thing that I really want us to get ahead of is we are having an industry that is becoming way more connected than ever, and it's becoming more homogeneous. The ability to do an attack in one location versus another used to be really, really hard. It's getting easier. That's not a this year problem, that's not a next year problem, that's a 5 to 10 year challenge, but we're gonna hit this inflection point. And right now we're only dealing with state actors because it's a lot of investment. You make that inflection point, you start dealing with criminal and other non-state actors. That's gonna be bad. So it's not, oh my God, we're all gonna die, go do work. It's, hey, we can see where we're going, let's get ahead of it. Let's make sure that we're good for the long term. That's why we wanna put this stuff in place now, just make sure our communities are taken care of. Oh, I love the people. And so, I mean, I think it's in the theme of the human element, but nobody paid me to, like, you know, slip me to be like, human element. But but honestly, like, I see a lot of conversations around RSA in general, and I've always loved coming here. It's like the designated conference to go hang out with all the people you like and see every time. There's so many people here that are, like, in my community, industrial, which you never think of RSA, the Enterprise Security Conference, as having anything industrial. And yet, if the world is industrial, then yeah, we're all still here anyways. And so it was really, really cool to see all the customers, see all of our partners, our friends, and peers. And yeah, it's a little bit of just excitement for the community in general.